everyone, and welcome back to Sword Art Online Alicization Rising Steel. Today we are here for a new gacha. It has been a while, mainly because I didn't want to spend too much time on the gacha and focus on the events since they are the main focus of this game. This time we have a new allies. She comes from the latest episodes of the anime where she returned to the real world in a robot body. So this is basically real world allies, which is pretty new. I also wanted to give you guys a schedule update on stuff as usual, but you know the drill by now that on the weekends we have the event stories and then whenever we can we do a gacha. Probably before the event story if possible, like this time, if not as soon as possible. Ok, so let's go into the gacha, let's not waste time since we have a ton of diamond cubes as you can see. We will start with the free scout. I saved them just for you guys since of course they can be fun to see, especially if we pull a new unit. And then we go into the allies gacha. We will do probably 5 steps because I do want to save up for a future unexpected banner, but 5 steps should be enough to get a new unit, especially the new allies. Most of the time we don't get the new unit in particular, but we just get a new unit overall. So hopefully the trend continues, because I prefer to get new units rather than get a dupe, and then that's useless. So let's skip this one, since we didn't get anything, and it is a free one, so we won't waste any time. And let's get into the allies gacha, here we go. So, for you guys that wonder what you should pull, we will do that later, because we have a lot of good banners actually, and the new heroes probably is the worst one to pull on, because as you can see we have guaranteed 4 star banners for every color in the game, with very very good units in them, so I will tell you later which banner probably you should roll on, and I will do an analysis on allies as a whole. Probably you can already tell that the light one is one of the best one since it has the Anniversary Kirito and Idis, which are still very very good. Also, I like the Valentine Celebration banner, it is overall decent since it has also rain. Ok, so let's start and go into this gacha and see if we manage to pull allies. You know, in my language we will call her Alice, which sounds a little bit better, but since in the anime she's called Alice, we'll respect the wish of the characters in the game and call her that, so we do have a sort of difference in language, but I will call her Alice, so don't worry my friends. We've also seen from news into the media sphere of Rising Steel that we are going to get some very very sweet new stuff. To do a general recap of it while we go through this lackluster 11 pool, we will have a new raid boss mode where the boss basically has pieces that you can attack instead of only one body, and destroying the pieces will get you more points in this sort of point based event. Sort of like the ranking system, if I had to guess, but in a different way. Then we saw that they will add illustrations, like the character illustration for example, as a way to boost your character stats. For example, like the Weird Prince or the Craft Essence in Fate and Dragalia, if I had to guess. And we can equip those in the main screen, much like I did with my characters, like Asuna, Summer Asuna, if you saw her earlier. They will cost diamond cubes, so it is quite a hefty price to get this going, but I am sure that we will find a good use for this, even in the channel. I will surely want to cover those whenever they come, hopefully it's not too far away. They also have shown that there is a contest for a new TS with a ballroom gown, which is something you wear whenever you go dance in a sort of royal scenario. And it looks like the candidates are doing a very 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 well done job with the designs. I like a lot of them actually, so make sure to see them, check them out and see which one you like and let me know, since I think that having a sort of user-themed costume for the game is always cool to see. Nothing so far, but nothing too surprising, the game doesn't really love to give handouts in general, so we will have to wait until we receive the guaranteed 4 star, which is at the 5th 11 pool, which isn't too far away. It is also the main reason for why I suggest that you guys roll on the other banners, because of course rolling a 11 pull and then getting nodding can be quite discouraging, especially if you are a new player which needs to get new units. As a new player, you should probably focus on the guarantees, so that's what I'm trying to tell you, because those will give you a lot more worth in the pulls as a whole. I believe that there isn't anything else that they told in the announcement. I believe there was a lot of quality of life stuff, which always is very decent for the player base as a whole. I believe they said that they will buff the Imaginarium of older characters, which is very good because older characters are kinda falling off very badly in all type of content, and basically they are becoming worse than 3 and 2 stars at this point, because they are basically useless. Even if you pull them, you basically get nothing worth. I guess you get the crystals, which is decent. Crystals are still very useful as a whole to the game, so at least that can be relevant. I also saw that they are going to give us, I believe, a full amount of crystals for a limit break of a character, which will help a lot also for new players, because they are, I remember that they are colorless and on color. I said the colorless twice, wouldn't make a lot of sense because of that. Man, I'm getting kinda fed up that we always get a trash luck before the last full, however, because it usually goes like this. We go into the step 5 and then the unit arrives or it doesn't. So until then, it's basically a snorefest because nothing goes on, and so you probably guys can't enjoy the gacha aspect of this. I know my luck will do better, but I've not been rolling for such a long time that it is what it is. Oh, as usual, don't forget that after the Should You Pull, we will go and do the Awakening of the Week, which is where I limit break a unit and we check out their limit break art. I believe this week I probably want to do a light or an earth character, since I do have more than 400 colorless crystals, so finally I can limit break one of the earth units that we've gotten in the past. Maybe Summer Lisbeth, but we will see. I did promise you guys that I will limit break Summer Lisbeth, but I still haven't decided as a whole. There are a ton of very good earth characters that I've gotten thanks to the free pulls. I believe that I've gotten the Earth Suna, which actually is a very good character that I could use in my Earth team, but in general I don't really have an Earth team because they are all underleveled apart from the Leafa. You know, that's maybe why I'm getting a trash luck in this banner, because there was a Leafa banner and I didn't pull on it. But now is the time of the guaranteed. You might ask why I didn't you pull in the Leafa banner since you have all the Leafas. Because I thought that it was kinda bad, like she's not bad as a unit, but the banner is kinda... This one instead I am rolling because I want the new allies, even though the banner I know is bad, so it is what it is. I kinda changed my mind in a week, which can happen, I guess, because we are humans. Ooh, we got her! That's the guaranteed, because it shows the unit that you're going to get. Crazy, but it kinda stole the surprise, if I had to guess, so there it is. As usual, when we get the new unit animation, I will shut up and let you guys see the special move, because that's more important than me talking over it, I guess. So let's see how long before she comes, but we got the guaranteed animation, so... Oh man, kinda getting... You know, the delay in the character appearing makes me think that it's allies, but then it's a 2-star character, so I'm kinda getting tricked by this, so let's hope that she's the next one. No, it is Kibau for the 4th time in this pool. The guy from the village in Alicization. Let's see if the next one. No, the Sleeping Guild. Kate Seat, okay. I was about to remember that. Come on, Alice, be the next one, please! No, it's the sister, no, it's the friend of TS and Ron.
Ah! 守るべきもののために私は戦う。
And there we go. A very, very beautiful Alice. Probably one of the most original designs that they had for her, outside of all the armored Alice that we got and some of the normal clothes. This is probably one of my favorites because she also has a different weapon type. So far I believe that most of the Alice have been sword. This one is Great Sword, which I believe only her and Berkuli and maybe One Iris have this sword type, which I'm actually very happy about, since of course we don't really see it used too much and I like different weapons as a whole. She also seems to be a very very good character because she has both Enhanced Mode and also Special Partner with Kirito. The light meta actually has a very good Kirito in it, which is the one with the double sword and Yucho in their special move, so I can safely say that she probably will have a very good place in a light team, especially if you are going to go for the ranking for this month. So let's see what this Alice does with the next Shulyu Bull. So as I told you, she is an Enhanced Mode, her special partner is Kirito, she has Break, Assault and Enhance. We have Break, which is a single enemy slash attack with a physical res debuff, helps a lot, especially since the most recent units have interaction with debuff of physical or magic res debuff, and Break overall is very good for light because we don't have a lot of good Break characters. Most of the good light characters usually are charge, so she fits a very good role in light as a whole. Assault is a single enemy slash attack that deals additional damage to enemies with a physical res or magic res debuff. As you can tell, this works together with the Break and other units in light that are recent at least that inflict those type of debuff. Then we have the Enhanced Mode, but those, you get the idea, so it is the usual, you get enhanced abilities whenever you are inside of it. Then we have Incarnate Skill, which is a Photon Buster Blade. This is also single enemy slash attack, which deals additional damage with physical res or magic res debuff. All of this deals way more damage during Enhanced Mode. Since she is recent, she also has a Leader Skill, which increases your light elemental attack by 5%. So overall, a very good package for a light character. Now let's go and see the stats. As you can see, she is physical attack based, not a surprise. Actually very decent defenses and crit, and not a bad speed. So overall, this Alice has a well-rounded package. But as usual, the main problem for Enhanced Mode characters is the MP, as you can see right here, which isn't a whole lot. But thanks to the recent accessory change, you can do some work with this, especially if you roll a good accessory, you can work around this to make a very good character. So, nothing else to say right here, we already described what she does with the moves. We can see the Enhanced Mode details, which probably improves her Incarnate Break up to 60%, which is actually not bad, usually it is 50. The Slash Attack deals way more damage, and the Enhanced Mode Incarnate Skill deals way more damage, so overall, way more damage with the Enhanced Mode on. Shulyu Bull for these allies. So, as usual, ranking characters, which is what allies is being a single target damage dealer, are very good if you are planning to go into the ranking. However, I will say this, for light we needed a good damage dealer that has Break, and with the fact that this allies also has Leader Skill, shares the member attack with Kirito, and then she also has Enhanced Mode, I can safely say that she's very very good. And with a kick-ass design like this, probably I do suggest that you try a roll for these allies. But if you are new, or if you have most of the units overall, probably I would wait and save for a better banner. Probably will come later on into the week, which is where you get a spotlight specifically for allies, and you will have better chances there. This banner usually is for those that don't have light units, or that want to roll allies with worse chances, so that's how it goes. You also get some good options in alternatives, like this Asuna is still very good, Iris, believe this one is from the anniversary, decent healer and charge, and then Kirito, which works very well alongside this new allies, which is also a Break character. So overall, a very good setup. Now, what else we have to check out, but of course, the rest of the banners. So what do I suggest you roll on? The Valentine Celebration is very good, because you get guaranteed on step 3, but I do think that the best banner out of those is the Pickable 4-star in this one right here. So you need to do 3 times, each step is relevant to your pool, since of course you need to reach the third one to get the character guarantee that you want, and you choose which one you want. Which one do I suggest? Probably the Light Kirito, the Light Tidus, or Rain for Earth, or the Earth Kirito, or even, let me see right here, we have the Fire Administrator is still very good, or the Wind Asuna are all very good options. Darkness Kirito is average, Darkness Subtilizer still is decent, so those are some very good options, but I suggest that you get the light units, since they are the most recent and also probably very good if you have their companion. In this case, it is Iris for Kirito and Kirito for Iris, so you get the idea. Then we have the Lunar New Year banners. Those are guaranteed 4 star for every pull that you do, but it is a one time only, so only one. I suggest that you do the light one, since you have the units from the Pickable 4 star here, and also, let me see right here, what else do we have? The Earth one seems to be also very very good, since we have the Earth Administrator Kirito and Earth Delegate Asuna, seems to be a very good choice. Ok, let's go and do the Awakening of the Week right here and see what we're up to. Let me see. Of course, you guys can already tell that I'm going to unlock the new Asuna. Sorry, not the new Asuna. Even though I wish that we got a new Asuna, but I believe that I've gotten all the Asunas from the free scouts, so it is what it is. I probably will do a 2-for-1 this time. I feel generous because we pulled the new allies. Where is she? Let me see. There she is, this one. Let me see what else we can unlock. I told you guys an Earth character. And there she is, the Earth Delegate Asuna that I wanted to do. Nice. Okay, so first let's start with allies and see if I have enough resources. Okay, I do. Good amount of free pulls right here. Let's see. Boom, one. Let's go for 2. Ok, I am so excited to see how this goes, since of course we do have a lot to cover, so. And there she is, Limit Break Alice from the new Gacha. Very very pretty. This is indeed from the latest episode of the anime, so I'm happy to say that we got a very sweet deal, since she's not even limited, I believe, since it is not a seasonal one. And I'm very happy that we've gotten her. Probably one of my most awaited characters, or rather not awaited because I wanted a new allies in general, but one of my most liked characters that they did in this game. She really is very pretty indeed. Let's see if I have also a good weapon. Oh, she's not a great sword. I thought that she was. I got deceived by the weapon. Okay, I still got a short sword for sure, so nothing to worry. So that was kinda deceiving, because she had a great sword in the animation, but instead it is only a normal one. I wonder why they went with this odd decision. But okay, there we go, everything will be unlocked right here, as you can see. And now she's ready to go for battle. The second one will be our Earth Delegate Asuna. If I believe it is Earth Delegate, it could be Swordsman Delegate, which is a lot more different than I was saying, which actually would make a lot more sense, but I apologize for the disguise, sorry, not disguise, for the misname, if that is the case, but here she is. I believe that the art is her holding a pie, so let's see if I am right. Indeed it is. Very, very good. Here we go. Another Asuna added to our collection. Let's power her up to full as well, and see if we have enough resources for the grid as a whole. There we go. Full lineup. Boom. I love to have the full unlock. It makes my job a whole lot easier. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, guys. Let me do some changes in my home screen right here, since by now I believe that I earned myself a new allies on the main screen. Maybe I will put her instead of Leafa. Leafa kinda has gone sour in the latest months, so here she is. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Remember to a like and a sub if you want to support the channel. Remember to tune in tomorrow for the follow-up to the IDIS and the Orphanage event. And remember to a like and a sub if you want to support the channel. We will come back with another gacha very soon, depending on how much it takes me to reach 1k diamond cubes once again, but I will see you then, whenever it is. Hopefully you get your own allies from the gacha if you are going to roll, or hopefully you get a good alternative if you don't. This has been Hunter Lodge, the new allies, and for today I can safely say that we won and we're out.